Hello. I hope this is recording this time. Again, this is Amanda Ripley, and I'm here on the ship because, like I said in past videos that I have been sending out, that I'm looking for my mother, Warrant Officer Ellen Ripley. And last night, for whatever reason, the file that I tried sending was corrupt. So I thought that what I would do, well, first of all, forgive me for not showing myself with the camera. I'm a wreck this morning. Haven't been getting much sleep ever since I've been on the ship. It's been a real hellish nightmare for me. So that's the reason why. I thought that I would go back, if I'm able. I thought that I would go back and see if I can retrace my steps, so you can see exactly what you missed. And then we can continue into the unknown. Let me through the elevator. This is not the way. Okay. So that's not the way. Or rather, this is the way, but apparently I think it's sealed off now. Let's see. Yeah. I believe this was the way. Whoa. How would I fire my gun? Oh, like this. Okay. Well, I guess I could say it better. I'll say it in my own words. Through here, there's an elevator over there. And what happened was, what the last thing you remember, what you guys saw, was that I was in a room where I found this revolver, and I managed to find the cells I was looking for my, well, I can't find it now, so I don't know how to go into my inventory, but, and, that mobile device thing that I have used to hack the doors. So I found the cells for that. And then I had to restore power to get the elevators moving. So I used my mobile device to hack some doors to unlock them, to go into them that I wasn't able to get into before. And then in one of the rooms, I saw it. Some creature, some xenomorph. It came from the goddamn air shaft that was up in the ceiling, these holes. And it came down, and I hid under the desk, and it didn't see me. So the alarm started going off, lo and behold, which is probably what caused the alien, drew the alien's attention. So I went to the computer when the alien was out of sight, which seemingly disappeared out of nowhere. I shut the alarm off, and then I worked my way around the station. And I didn't know what to do next, so I aimlessly wandered around until it hit me. I have that mobile device, so I can hack the door of where I came from and go back and backtrack to where those thugs were, you know, where that girl was, where I first found that mobile device and she was trying to hack that door to get into the elevator. Well, guess what? Now I have the cells, so I could do it. So, of course, lo and behold, I hacked the door and I got in. And then I heard the most terrifying screams I've ever heard in my life. So I went around a corner and I crouched down and I looked at the floor below me and I saw it. That goddamn xenomorph again was killing everyone. And I heard the cries and screams of a woman, probably that same woman that shot at me when I first went there into that room, you know, the beginning of all this. Not the whole thing, but, you know, when I first went into that room. And I went down, I snuck around that alien xenomorph creature and quickly started hacking the door. But I could hear behind me, there was the cries and scream that kind of like, not the screams, but she was just the panicking sounds of a woman. Like I said, that same woman that shot at me. And I quickly turned around and I started just turning my head looking, seeing if I can't see her and find her, but it was too late. I panicked, the elevator door opened. I went through it and I pushed a button. And although it pains me to have done it, I left her behind. So I'm up here now. The elevator door was right there. And I went through here and I saw these two people run past me from right to left. And here I am now. And this asshole here wasn't any help. So I started working my way. I need a key card for this. Now just keep in mind, I'm past all this. I continue to use my mobile device. I'm not even sure if that's the right word for it, but the thing I use for hacking the door is to open them up. And I went through here. And I'm not sure if I actually been here, but some things I wasn't able to do anything about it. Like I need an ion torch. So there was nothing I can do about it. So I went through here and there was really nothing. And this guy here, of course, was of no help. What's this? I need a key card to get in there, that's right, and I couldn't get in there. Okay. So I started thinking to myself, God, there are a lot of robots here, or as some people call them, synthetics, but they don't like that term. They prefer the word artificial human themselves. So I kept going. And I think over here I found something here, like a battery, I think. And so that's right. I went into this room here, you know, I hacked the door, and okay, I'm full on ethanol now apparently. So I'm gonna see if there ain't anything I can't do about that. No. Ah, there is. What? Well, I really don't know what's going on there, but I mean, maybe I can take this now. And I can. See, and I made a comment here about this fan. Yeah, it's hot as hell, so I kind of needed that. Ah. Right, and just some stuff I read in a terminal, which I can't remember anymore. My mind is so jumbled because, like I said, I haven't been getting much sleep. Last night I actually slept in one of those ventilation ducts. How I live now. And now this is where we left off, where I went to a recording station to save my footage and to send it off back to Earth just to document everything. And lo and behold, the file was corrupted, probably during my escape with the alien, that xenomorph, when I started running away. And I might have fallen down and it broke it, but it doesn't matter. I found a pack of new cartridges to record. And the sad thing about these cassettes to save them on, the tapes to save them on, is that there's only one slot. Sadly enough, there's only one slot, okay? So that's why. Otherwise, I would have made a second recording of it, and then it would not have been lost footage. And all I managed to do was kind of poke my head out here, and I opened that up, and there was something. Oh, here's some scraps there, but I won't take that now. I'm gonna rest. This took a lot out of me. And I heard some terminology called the Working Joes, so we're gonna see what that's all about later. Okay? So, this is Amanda Ripley looking for her mother, Warrant Officer Ellen Ripley, signing off.